गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबॉडी। हाँ
मॉर्निंग मिस, गुड मॉर्निंग मिस।
या गुड मॉर्निंग, कैन यू वन सेकेंड लेट मी। आंसर योर अटेंडेंस। अफला,
प्रेजेंट मिस,
अजमिना,
प्रेजेंट
अमेया,
मिस,
अतुल्या, ऋष्या,
प्रेजेंट मिस, प्रेजेंट मिस,
ज्योतिष,
प्रेजेंट मिस,
कार्तिक, काव्या,
प्रेजेंट मिस,
नचिकेतस,
प्रेजेंट मिस।
नीरज, रंगीत,
प्रेजेंट
वैष्णव, वैष्णव,
मिस,
अंजलि,
प्रेजेंट मिस,
श्रुति,
प्रेजेंट मिस,
कार्तिक इज देयर, इज नॉट देयर। ओके ओके, वेलकम बैक टू द क्लास। Next hour also I'll be handling because there is an alteration today. Fifth hour I won't be handling. Instead of that, I'll be handling third hour. Okay, so last class we were just discussing about, have you done that problem? We were discussing about the link state routing algorithm, right? And I have given you two problems based on that. Did you work out? Yes, okay. I'll be just telling it in the next class because I have to complete few topics today itself, and we will be discussing the answers in the next class. Okay. So the next topic what we are going to see today is the routing protocols. The next topic what we are going to see today is the routing protocols. I have told you, I have given a brief introduction of the routing protocols in the beginning. What are the different types of routing protocols, how it is being classified, etc. So usually these routing protocols are nothing but they are the set of, you are having some rules as well as some procedures which allows the routers to share whatever they know about the internet or their neighborhood. The meaning is you have to share what all information you are getting from the neighbors or what information you know about the internet, you have to share it. Okay, so you have to follow some sets and procedures, rules and procedures for that. That is nothing but the routing protocols. Now you can have several different routing protocols. Out of that, the first one is the routing information protocol. The second one is the open shortest path first, and the third one is the border gateway protocol. I have told you these names in the two or three classes before. I have just told all these names. So the routing protocols are nothing but the routing information protocol. In short, you can call it as RIP. Then open shortest path first, that is OSPF, and the last one is the border gateway protocol or BG. Now, see, since one, if you're having one protocol, it is not able to manage the entire internet network. So what it is being done is your internet network is divided it into autonomous system. Now, what is an autonomous system? An autonomous system is a group of networks or routers under the authority of a single administration, right? So everything is monitored under a single administration. So your internet network is being divided it into autonomous systems. Okay, now if you want to perform routing inside the autonomous system, you can have, I mean, it is done in two ways. One is intra-domain routing and the other one is the inter-domain routing. Now, what is intra-domain routing means? Inside the autonomous system, if you want to perform this routing, you can call it as intra-domain routing or internal routing. And if it is, if you want to perform between the autonomous system, you can call it as inter-domain routing. Okay, and you have got several protocols, and you have learned also a few protocols based on this. One is distance vector algorithm, and other one is the link state algorithm. Okay, now I hope you know what is the difference between distance vector routing algorithm and as well as the link state routing algorithm. So first, we will discuss about the first type of routing protocol called the routing information protocol or RIP. Now, what is the importance of this one? Now, actually, this is a distance vector protocol based on the hop count matrix. So routing information protocol is nothing but it is an implementation of distance vector protocol, and mainly it is based on the hop count matrix. Now, what do you mean by hop count? Hop count means when a router forward a data packet to a network segment, you can count it as a single hop. If you want to forward your data packet to a segment, now you can call it as a single hop. Now you can see it in the diagram. You can have many routers connected, when R1, R2, R3, R4, etc. up to R8. So if R1 is forwarding the packet to R2, you can call it as one hop. Okay, so you can call it as one hop. If from R2 to R3, you have having again one hop. This is also one hop. So when from R1 to R4, if you want to forward the packet, the total number of hops required is equal to 3. Understanding, what do you mean by hop count? If a router forwards a data packet to a network segment, you can count it as a single hop. So from R1 to R2, you can take it as one hop. From R2 to R3, another hop. And R3 to R4, another hop. Okay, so this routing information protocol, what it does is it supports a maximum of 15 hop counts. It supports a maximum of 15 hop counts. The meaning is only 16 routers you can be configured in this routing information protocol. In this protocol, what it has been told is you are having only 15. The RIP protocol support maximum of 15 hop counts. If you want to do 15 hop counts, now what is the maximum number of routers that is possible or configured is equal to 16 routers. And that is the major disadvantages of this RIP. Understanding? Yes or no?
Yes, miss.
Yes, okay. So I have told about routing information protocol. It is mainly based on the hop count matrix. Now, it is the total number of hop counts possible in RIP is 15. And that is the disadvantage of this RIP. Now, how does this RIP works? Now, you can see in the diagram, you can having 8 different routers which are connected to a network. Now, suppose if R1 want to send a data to R4. If R1 wants to send a data to R4, and if the network is configured in RIP, now what route it will choose in order to reach the destination? Now, in this diagram, when you are looking into this diagram, you can see through 3 routes you can reach your destination. The first route is this manner, right? The first route, you can go from R1, R2, R3 and R4. The second route that is possible is directly like this. And the third route that is possible is directly like this. So totally 3 routes are possible in case of if you want to transfer of, if you want to forward a packet from R1 to R4. But if your network is implemented with RIP protocol, now which route it will be selecting? I have told you it is based on the minimum hop counts. The least number of hops only it will be considering. So we're just having the least hop now. See, if we want R1 to R4, the total number of hops in the first route will be equal to 3. Now what is the number of hops from R1 to R4? Directly connecting through R5, you're having one hope, so totally 2 hopes you require. And here you require 4 hopes. So out of these, this R1 will be selecting only this path. That is route 2 will be selected. and that is having the minimum or the least number of hops. Understanding how is the RIP protocol works. So since it is having only two hop count to reach the router R4, it will be selecting the second route. The first route is having three hops, it won't consider that. The third route also it is having four hops, so it won't be considering. Right? Now consider this another one more example. Now here you can have totally six routers connected. Now if you want to deliver a packet from R1 to R4, now what are the possible routes here? Now you can have route 1 through this path as well as route 2 through this path. Understanding? Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay, so you are having six routers here that is being connected in a network. R1 wants to send a data to R4. Now what are the possible routes? This is your route 1 and this is your route 2, right? Now what is the maximum number of hops in order to reach R4? When you are considering route 1, the total number of hops that is equal to 3 hops, right? And here also you are requiring 3 hops. Now what if a network is implemented using RIP protocol? Now which route it will be selected? So the router will send the packet via both the routes. Since you are having equal number of hops, what the router will do is it will send the data through both the paths or both the routers at the same time. The meaning is it is managing the load balancing. Load balancing is done here. And your data will be reaching your destination in a faster manner. Okay, so that is the working principle, how this RIP works. It is considering only the minimum number of hop counts. If the hop counts are same, what it will be doing is it will be sending through both the routes at the same time. So load balancing is managed in that case. Okay, now what are the disadvantages of this RIP? I have told you already what are the disadvantages. The first one is it is based on hop count matrix. It is not at all considering any other method or any other way. It is considering only the hop count, right? So if there is a better route available with more bandwidth, RIP is not going to choose that particular route. The concept is, see, suppose in the right hand side, you can see a diagram. See, if I want to forward a packet from R1 to R3, the possible routes are through this route, and through this route also it is possible, right? Now, which is having the minimum number of hops? Here you are considering three hops, it is there. Here you have two hops, and here you have one, two, three, four hops. So only through this path, only the packet is being forwarded. But what happens? Is you can see the router R2 is connected to many other routers, right? So you are having a lot of traffic in this particular route. Okay, so but the router who is making use of this RIP protocol, they are not at all worrying about that. They are not going to check that. So what they will do is they will count the minimum hops, they will be sending that packet. Maybe the other route, that is route 1, there is no much traffic and it can reach the destination in a faster manner, but it is not considering that, right? So instead of this, the data will be passing only through route 2 and it will be slower due to the heavy traffic. Okay, so that is the disadvantages of this RIP protocol. Right? Now the second disadvantage is RIP broadcasts the updates to the entire network and creates a lot of traffic, right? And the third one is bandwidth utilization is high. I have told you about the periodic updates when I was discussing about distance vector routing algorithm. You have two types of updates. One is the periodic update and the triggered update. Periodic update, every 30 seconds, the router will be sharing its information. Since it is broadcasting, the bandwidth utilization is very high. Okay, and also it supports only 15 hops. The meaning is maximum 16 routers only can be connected at a time. So it is suitable for only a lesser network, a less number of routers. If you are configuring it, you can make use of this RIP protocol, right? Other than this disadvantages, you have got some advantages also. It is easy to configure and you are having less CPU utilization. Okay, now, how this RIP updates its routing table. Now, what are the different timers available? How it is getting updated? So the first timer is called it as the update timer. I have told you every 30 seconds, all the routers which are configured with this RIP send their update in every 30 seconds, right? So that is the update timer. Now, the second one is the invalid timer. Invalid timer means if any of the router gets disconnected from the network, now, what the neighbor router will do is it will wait for 180 seconds to hear the update. Now, if it is not receiving any update, what it will do is it will be marking that route as not reachable. Okay, so that is the timer is for waiting timers or for the getting the updation. So invalid timer is if a router is not getting disconnected from the network, now the what the neighbor will router will do, it is not getting any updates. So what it will do, it will wait for about 180 seconds to hear some update. So now if it is not receiving, then it will think that the router is not reachable. Right? Now the third type of timer is called the flush timer, or it is 240 seconds, approximately 4 minutes. So if the router does not go up or it is not sending the update till 4 minutes, now what the neighbor router will do, it will be completely removing that route from the routing table. Okay, so that is the importance of flush timer. So each router, if it is not getting any update from the neighbor, what they will do is they will just completely remove that particular route from their routing table. Right? So this is how it updates with the help of this timers. Now, this is just an example of a domain using this RIP protocol. Now you can see a network here. So you can see an autonomous system here which consists of, you have 4 routers here, R1, R2, R3, and R4, and you have got 7 networks also. This denotes a network actually, okay? So I have told you, autonomous system, you are having routers, you are having networks, you are having, networks is called it as links, everything is present. So each router, they will be having a routing table, right? So this is the routing table for R1, this is for R2, this is for R3, and this is for R4. Okay, so all the routers will be having a routing table. Now, what does the first column indicates? The first column indicates the network address. Okay, now the second column is nothing but the total number of hop counts. Okay, the number of links in order to reach the destination. What is the total number of hop count in order to reach your next path? Right? Now, the next node column, that is the last column, it defines the address of the router to which the packet is to be sent to reach its destination. Maybe through multiple routers, your network is being connected and your destination is connected. And if you want to deliver it, then you have to reach the next hop each time, and then you will be reaching your destination. Right? Now, if you are considering the routing table for R1, so just assume this is the routing table, you can have how many entries? 4, 5, 6, 7 entries you can have. So what it indicates that it is showing how to reach each network in an autonomous system. You have to reach your network, and that is, I have told, this is an autonomous system. Now, the router R1, it is directly connected to 2 routers, that is R2 and R4. Right? It is directly connected to the networks R2 and as well as R4, where you are having the network addresses. Okay, so you don't have any hop entries here for these 2 networks because it is directly connected. This column is left it as blank. Okay, now remaining routers, if towards left hand side, if you can see, you have to reach your networks on the left hand side by either through R2 or through R3. And it is based upon the addresses that has been given. Now towards right hand side also, if you want to reach your networks 205.5.5 as well as 205.6, you have to reach your router R4, then only you can reach your network. Okay, so that is the concept of this RIP protocol. Each router is having a routing table which indicates the destination hops as well as the next hop address. Okay, so this is all about RIP, that is Routing Information Protocol. So what is the major thing in routing information protocol, RIP protocol? Can anybody summarize it, how an RIP protocol works? Karthik is there? Yes, Karthik is there? No, he is not there. Then who will be answering? Afla, you can answer. Give a summary of what you have.
Calculating the hops and...
Yeah, RIP is mainly based on what? It is based on the hop count.
Based on the hop count matrix.
Yeah, that is the major disadvantages also, because if you want to deliver a packet from one router with minimum number of hosts, maybe that router might be heavy traffic will be there. So the system, data will be transferred in a less slow manner. Okay, so that is the disadvantage. Understood what is RIP, how it works, and what are the how a domain is being connected using this RIP protocol. Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay. Right. Now we will just move on to the second type of protocol. All these protocols are very, very important. See, once RIP protocol is asked for you, you have to write what is the working principle. You have to show with a diagram also that is missing in your assignments also that is missing. See, when you are writing your assignments, your course note as well as your PPT, everything as well as your textbook, everything, you have to refer it and you have to answer it. See, I will show you one scheme what it is being given from the university. Every question they are giving the marks for the figure. If it is a 10 marks essay question, 7 marks only is allotted for the theory part. 3 marks is for the figure. And I have told you many times that if some figure is there, you have to draw it. That will make you get more marks. That is also, again, not done in your assignments also. Okay, in way that corrections, I'll be telling it in the next class. What I was telling is, if RIP protocol is asked, you have to just explain with a diagram also. Then only you will be getting marks. Okay. Right. So you have to refer both the PPT as well as the notes, what I have distributed, or any other, the textbook is better. You have to refer the textbook and just you have to answer it. Right. Now, the second type of protocol is routing protocol is called it as open shortest path first. Open shortest path first. Now, this is an intra-domain routing protocol. I have told you two protocols you have under intra-domain. First one is RIP and the second one is the OSPF. Now, this is based on link state routing. So this OSPF, it is based on this link state routing. Now, what the OSPF will do? Now, this OSPF, what you will be having? One second. Okay. So what it will do is you will have autonomous system, and what the OSPF will do is it will divide the autonomous system into areas. So you can see here area 1, area 2, area 0. So the main thing is if you have an autonomous system, you will be dividing it into several areas. Now each area will be a combination of your network, your routers, maybe some host also, if it is connected, that also will come into picture. Okay, so it is a collection of, each area is a collection of network, host, and routers. Right? Now, routers inside the area, they flood the area with routing information. What all information is getting in this router, they will be flooding it. Flooding, I have told you what is mean by flooding. Flooding means sharing of information, right? So routers inside the area flood the area with your routing information. Now, at the border of each area, you can have a special router. Now, these routers are called it as area border router. These routers are called it as area border router. Now, what this router will do is they will summarize the information about the area and send it to other areas. You have an area border router here, and what it will do, it will cumulatively, it will summarize all the information belonging to this area and they will share it to the other areas. Right? Now, all the areas inside the autonomous system, it must be connected to a backbone network. That is called it as the primary area. You have different areas. Now, whatever, how many areas are there, all these areas must be connected to a backbone router. You can just see it in the diagram. So the meaning is you have an internet network. You will be dividing it into autonomous system, right? Autonomous system. And this autonomous system, again, it will be divided it into various areas in the case of this OSPF protocol. Okay, so this is just the architecture of OSPF. You have got the autonomous system is divided it into various areas. Each area is nothing but it is a collection of routers, networks, host, etc. You will be having routing tables inside each areas, and area border router, what it will do is they will collect all the information from that particular area and they will be sharing it to the other areas. And all these areas must be connected to a backbone router. Okay, so this is just the architecture. So this backbone, this is called it as the primary area, and all these are called it as these, all these areas, area one, area two, are called it as the secondary areas, right? So this is just the architecture. Now, what are the links in OSPF protocol? You have got four different types of links. One is point-to-point, another one is transient, the third one is stub, and fourth one is virtual. Now, what is all this? You can have types of links as point-to-point, transient, stub, and virtual. So what is a point-to-point link? Point-to-point link means it connects two routers without any other host or router in between. You don't have anything in between. You are directly connected to routers. Such type of connection is called it as point-to-point link. Okay, now the second one is called it as the transient link. So transient link means it is a network with several routers attached to it. You have a cable and you have a link and all the routers are attached to it. You have two representation based on that. One is unrealistic representation and realistic representation. So transient link is many routers will be there and they will be connected to a common link, right? Now, the third one is called it as the stub link. Stub link means it is a network that is connected to only one router. You are having only one router and you will be connected to the link. Okay, so the meaning is the data packets enter the network through this single router and it will leave the network through that router itself. Okay, so data is entering the network through a single router and leave the network through the same router. So such a type of connection is called it as the stub link. Now the last one is called it as the virtual link. You know what is the meaning of virtual? Virtual, imaginary. So if the link between two routers is broken, now what the administrator will do, they may create some virtual link between them using a bigger path. So suppose if you have a network here, okay, so if you have a network here where many routers will be connected, suppose if or this is two routers, and if one of the router, if the link between the two routers is broken, now what it will do, a virtual path, the administrator, they will create a virtual path either through this, many routers will be connected here also, you just assume it as many routers, so they will direct the traffic through this way or virtually they will be doing that. Okay, so creates a virtual connection if the link is broken in between. Okay, so these are the types of links in this OSPF protocol. Now the next one is called it as the OSPF packets. Right, now you have got five different types of packets. First packet is called it as the hello packet. Second one is the database description. Third one is the link state request. Fourth one is link state update, and fifth one is link state acknowledgement. I'll be just giving the explanation once I explain the frame format, right? So these are the packets available in OSPF. Now you have a frame format or a packet format in this OSPF. Now the first field, you are having the version. Version, it defines the OSPF protocol. Now the second field is called it as the type. Type means this is what? The type of the packet. It belongs to either of this five, whether it is a hello packet or a link state request or a link state acknowledgement. So that will be defined in this field, which is of 8 bits. Now the third field is called it as the message field. Message means you can call it as the length of that field. Means the message, the total number of bits that is made uses 16. It consists of the message as well as the header length. So that is being represented here. Now you have the source IP address. That is, you will have the IP address of the sending router, and you have area identification. Area identification, where routing is taking place, that is defined here. Which area? It defines the area where routing takes place. Now you have the checksum for error detection, and you have the authentication type. The authentication type, the value can be either 0 or 1. So 0 means you don't have any authentication, it is not based on any authentication, and if it is 1 means it is password based authentication, right? Now this authentication, it is of 32 bits, means you have some data values in this, and that will be represented in this field. Okay, so this is the OSPF frame format, where you have different fields like version, type, message, source IP address, area identification, or checksum, authentication type, and the authentication. The bracket, what it has been written is, it will denote the total number of bits. Right? Now, what about the packets? I have told you the first packet is called it as the hello packet. So hello packet, okay, hello packet is used to have or used to create the neighborhood relationship. So you want to speak to the neighbors. You want to find how they are reachable. You want to test the reachability of neighbors. So if you want to make a connection between the other routers, initially what you will be doing is you will be sending the hello packets. Okay, so when the connection is to be made between routers, you will be making use of this hello packets. Now the second type of packet is called it as the database description. Database description means once the router is connected, the hello message is forwarded, and after that, if for the first time if a neighbor wants to connect it, now they make use of this database description. Now, initially, if a new neighbor is coming and they want to know, they want to get an idea of the other routers, then what they will do is they will ask for the database description, right? Now, the third one is called it as the link state request. Link state request means they are sent by a router that needs information about a specific route. If they want to get an information about a specific route, they will make use of this packet, that is link state request packet. Now the fourth packet is the link state update packet. Update packet, it is used by a router to advertise the states of the links. You know what is that update meaning? So they want to advertise what they know about their neighbor, so they will be just flooding it. So that is by making use of this link state update packet. Now the last packet is called it as the link state acknowledgement. See, OSPF means it is a reliable protocol. Now what it will do is it will force each router to acknowledge the receipt of the link state update. So if I'm a router, if I'm getting some updates from my neighbors, I want to acknowledge that router that I have received it. So I want to maintain the reliability. So that is done with the link state acknowledgement packet. Okay, so these are the things that you have to write when OSPF protocol is asked. You have to just define what are the packets, what are the frame format, what are the different types of links, and what is the working principle of this OSPF. Right, so OSPF, it is open shortest path first. It is an intra domain routing protocol, and it is based on the link state routing protocol. Link state routing, so just remember, what is link state? Link state, what is the difference between distance vector and link state? How it works, the shortest path that we'll be finding it out by making use of Dijkstra's algorithm, flooding takes place, everything. Now what is flooding? The main thing is each router is knowing the information about the neighbors, and they will be getting to know to all the routers present in the network. In distance vector, they were sharing only to their neighbors, but this is not the case in link state. They are sharing the information to all the routers present in that network. Okay, so that concept is coming here, right? Now, OSPF, what they will do is they will be just dividing the areas into various autonomous systems, and you will have an area border router, you will have a backbone router, and everything will be connected. And this is based on the architecture. Now, how it has been connected, you can have different types of links there, point-to-point, transient, stub, and virtual. Now, how the packet format you can, okay. Now, these are the packet format, the type of the packet. You will have a frame format in sending this packet. So, what it contains, what type of packet is, whether it is a hello packet, whether it is a link state request packet or update packet or an acknowledgement packet. Everything will be represented in that frame format. Okay, so you have to just remember this concept, right? Now, one more protocol is there, that is BGP, that we will be seeing it in the next class. And I hope you understood OSPF. Yes or no? OSPF is clear for you? What is?
Yes.
Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes, okay. So just remember that. What is the everything? See, maybe in my notes, this diagrams and all diagrams is there, but maybe so you refer the slides as well as the notes, because notes I am writing it in the middle. Maybe a few points will be added when I'm just taking the class thing. So mix it up and just write the concept of that. Okay. Now, what I need to tell is regarding your assignments. I have 3 more minutes here. Regarding your assignments, I have corrected your assignments and I have put your marks also. For the namesake, ദയവ് ചെയ്ത് അസൈൻമെന്റ്സ് നിങ്ങൾ കോപ്പി ചെയ്യാതെ എഴുതുക. ഒരാൾ ഒരു മിസ്റ്റേക്ക് ചെയ്തിട്ടുണ്ടെങ്കിൽ എല്ലാവരുടെയും പേപ്പറിൽ ആ മിസ്റ്റേക്ക് തന്നെയുണ്ട്. എനിക്ക് തോന്നുന്നു വോളണ്ടിയർ ആയിട്ട് ഒന്നോ രണ്ടോ പേരെ മാത്രമേ ആ അസൈൻമെന്റ്സ് കറക്റ്റ് ആയിട്ട് എഴുതിയിട്ടുള്ളൂ. ബാക്കി എല്ലാവരും ഒരാൾ അമ്മയ വാട്ട് മിസ്റ്റേക്ക് യു ഹാവ് മെയ്ഡ് ഇൻ ദറ്റ് അസൈൻമെന്റ് ദ സെയിം മിസ്റ്റേക്ക് ഇസ് റിപ്പീറ്റഡ് ബൈ അതുല്യ ആൻഡ് ദൃശ്യ. അമ്മയുടെ അസൈൻമെന്റ് നോക്കിയാന്നോ അതുല്യൻ ദൃശ്യം എഴുതിയത്? പറഞ്ഞേ പറഞ്ഞേ അതുല്യ ആൻഡ് തൃഷ്യ ആൻസർ മീ. അല്ല അല്ലയോ ആണോ?
അല്ല
അല്ല. ദൃശ്യ
ഒരു ക്വസ്റ്റിന്.
നമ്മൾക്ക് അസൈൻമെന്റ് എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് നിങ്ങൾ തന്നെ തന്നെ എഴുതാൻ ശ്രമിക്കുക. മറ്റുള്ളവരെ ഒരാളെ കോപ്പി ചെയ്ത് എഴുതിയത് തെറ്റാ. ഒന്നാമതേ മറ്റുള്ളവർക്ക് പറഞ്ഞു കൊടുക്കാം. യു റെഫർ, യു ജസ്റ്റ് ടെൽ, ഓക്കെ റെഫർ ദ ടെക്സ്റ്റ് ബുക്ക്, ദിസ് പേജ് യു ഹാവ് ദി ആൻസർ ഫോർ ദാറ്റ്. നൗ യു ക്രിയേറ്റ് യുവർ ഓൺ ഐഡിയാസ് ആൻഡ് യു റൈറ്റ് ദി ആൻസർ ഫോർ ദാറ്റ്. വിതൗട്ട് കോപ്പിംഗ് ഇറ്റ് ആൻഡ് റൈറ്റിംഗ് ദർ ഇസ് നോ യൂസ്. നിങ്ങളും അത് പഠിക്കത്തില്ല, എഴുതുന്നവരും പഠിക്കത്തില്ല. നൗ വാട്ട് മിസ്റ്റേക്ക് അതുല്യ, നിങ്ങൾ പറഞ്ഞു ഇപ്പൊ അത് നോക്കി എഴുതിയിട്ടില്ല എന്ന്, ബട്ട് യു ഹാവ് റിട്ടേൺ ഇറ്റ്. ഐ ഹാവ് ആസ്ഡ് യു അബൌട്ട് എ ആർ പി പ്രോട്ടോകോൾ ആൻഡ് ആർ എ ആർ പി പ്രോട്ടോകോൾ. അമ്മ അവിടെ ഒരു ചെറിയ മിസ്റ്റേക്ക് അവിടെ വരുത്തിയിട്ടുണ്ട്. ആ മിസ്റ്റേക്ക് തന്നെയാണ് അതുല്യം ദൃശ്യം അവിടെ വരുത്തിയിരിക്കുന്നത്. എ ആർ പി എന്നുള്ളതിന് അമ്മയ എഴുതിയത് എ ആർ ക്യൂ എന്നായിപ്പോയി. അവർ ഇവരും അത് തന്നെയാണ് ചെയ്തിരിക്കുന്നത്. നൗ ഡോണ്ട് ടെൽ ദാറ്റ് യു ഹാവ് നോട്ട് കോപ്പിഡ് ഫ്രം അമ്മയ. ഓക്കെ, സി ഇൻ മൈ കേസ് ഐ ബി കീൻലി സീയിങ് ഓൾ ദി അസൈൻമെന്റ്സ്. ഐ ബി സ്പ്ലിറ്റിംഗ് ഫോർ ഈച്ച് ക്വസ്റ്റൻ. ഐ ബി അലോട്ടിംഗ് സം മാർക്സ് ആൻഡ് ബേസ്ഡ് ഓൺ ദാറ്റ് ഓൺലി യുവർ ഫൈനൽ മാർക്സ് വിൽ ബി കമ്മിങ് ഇൻ ടു പിക്ചർ. ആൻഡ് രംഗീത് ഉണ്ടോ? രംഗീത്, രംഗീത് ഉണ്ടോ? ആ, യുവർ അസൈൻമെന്റ് മാർക്ക് സീറോ. എന്തുകൊണ്ടാന്ന് അറിയാം? നിങ്ങൾക്ക് അറിയത്തില്ല എങ്കിൽ അറിയത്തില്ല, വിട്ടേറെ ആ ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ. ആസ്ക് മീ ആൻഡ് ഡു ഇറ്റ്. ജസ്റ്റ് ടേക്കിംഗ് സംബഡീസ് റിട്ടേൺ അസൈൻമെന്റ് ആൻഡ് പുട്ടിംഗ് ഇറ്റ് ഇൻ എ പ്രിന്റ്, ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് ഇറ്റ് വോണ്ട് വർക്ക്. എന്റെ കേസിൽ അത് വർക്ക് ചെയ്യത്തില്ല. ഞാൻ പറഞ്ഞു ഓരോ അസൈൻമെന്റും ഡീപ്പായിട്ട് നോക്കിയിട്ടേ ഞാൻ മാർക്ക് ഇടത്തുള്ളൂ. സോ ഡോണ്ട് റിപ്പീറ്റ് ദാറ്റ്. രംഗീത്തിന് ഓൾറെഡി ഞാൻ വാർണിംഗ് തന്നതാണ് അങ്ങനെ ചെയ്യരുതെന്ന്, ബട്ട് യു ഹാവ് റിപ്പീറ്റഡ് ഇറ്റ് അഗെയിൻ ഓൾസോ. ആൻഡ് ദയവ് ചെയ്ത് നിങ്ങളുടെ അസൈൻമെന്റ്സ് അങ്ങോട്ടും ഇങ്ങോട്ടും ട്രാൻസ്ഫർ ചെയ്യാതിരിക്കുക. ഹെൽപ്പ് ചെയ്യാം, ബട്ട് നോട്ട് ബൈ ട്രാൻസ്ഫറിങ് ദ എക്സാക്ട് തിങ് വാട്ട് യു ഹാവ് റിട്ടൺ. ജസ്റ്റ് ടെൽ ടെക്സ്റ്റ് ബുക്കിൽ ഇന്ന പേജിലുണ്ട്, റെഫർ ഇറ്റ് ആൻഡ് റൈറ്റ് ഇറ്റ്. ഇത് നിങ്ങളാണ് പഠിക്കേണ്ടത്. കോപ്പി ചെയ്ത് എഴുതിയിട്ട് എന്താ പ്രയോജനം? നിങ്ങളത് എഴുതുമ്പോൾ ആത്മാർത്ഥമായിട്ട് നിങ്ങൾ തന്നെത്താനെ എഴുതുമ്പോഴേ നിങ്ങളത് പഠിക്കുകയുള്ളൂ. അതിനാണ് ഈ അസൈൻമെന്റ് തരുന്നത്. അതൊരു ബേർഡൻ ആയിട്ട് കാണാതെ 6 ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ തന്നതെന്ന് പറഞ്ഞു കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ ദ ഹോൾ മൊഡ്യൂൾ രണ്ട് ബാച്ചിനായിട്ട് ഞാൻ സ്പ്ലിറ്റ് ചെയ്ത് തന്നിരിക്കുക. സോ ദാറ്റ് അങ്ങനെ ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ വരുവാണെങ്കിൽ നിങ്ങൾക്കത് ആൻസർ ചെയ്യാൻ അറിയണം. അതിനാണ് അങ്ങനെ തന്നിരിക്കുന്നത്. എല്ലാവരും ഒരെണ്ണം നോക്കിയാൽ മതി, ബാക്കി എല്ലാം ഡിറ്റോ കോപ്പിയാണ്. സോ ഇനിയേലും അടുത്ത നെക്സ്റ്റ് മൊഡ്യൂൾ ഓൺവേർഡ്സ് ഡോണ്ട് റൈറ്റ് ഇറ്റ് ലൈക്ക് ദാറ്റ്. മിസ്റ്റേക്ക് എനിക്ക് പെട്ടെന്ന് കണ്ടുപിടിക്കാൻ ഒക്കും. ആരൊക്കെയാണ് മിസ്റ്റേക്ക് ചെയ്തത്? യു റെഫർ. ചിലത് കുറച്ച് പേര് ഒരു ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ എഴുതിയിട്ടില്ല, എന്നാൽ അത് വിളിച്ച് ചോദിക്കുക, ടീച്ചറെ അത് എങ്ങനെയാണ് എഴുതേണ്ടത്, ആൻഡ് ആൻസർ. ആൻഡ് ഫ്യൂ ഹാവ് റിട്ടൺ ദറ്റ് സിഡർ സ്കീം, കുറച്ച് പേര് അത് എഴുതിയിട്ടില്ല, അത് ഞാൻ നിങ്ങൾക്ക് ലിൻവേസിൽ എൻ്റെ എക്സാക്ട് വാട്ട് ഇസ് സിഡർ എന്നുള്ളതിനും ഒരു എക്സാമ്പിളും ഞാൻ അത് അയച്ചിട്ടുണ്ട്, അത് റെഫർ ചെയ്യുക ലിൻവേസിൽ, അത് പഠിക്കുക കേട്ടോ. യൂഷ്വലി ഇറ്റ് വിൽ ബി ആസ്ക്ഡ് സിഡർ സ്കീം ആസ് വെൽ ആസ് ദി സബ്നെറ്റ് മാസ്ക് എന്താന്നുള്ളത്, രണ്ട് ഡെഫിനിഷൻസ് ഞാൻ ലിൻവേസിൽ ഇട്ടിട്ടുണ്ട്. എനിക്ക് എത്ര പേര് നോക്കിയെന്ന് എനിക്കറിയില്ല. എനിവേ യു സ്റ്റഡി ഫോർ ദി എക്സാം, സീരിയസ് എക്സാം വരുന്നുണ്ട്, സോ പ്രിപ്പയർ ഫോർ ദാറ്റ്. ഓക്കെ, സോ വി വിൽ മീറ്റ് ഇൻ ദ നെക്സ്റ്റ് അവർ. ഐ ഡോണ്ട് വോണ്ട് ടു സ്പോയിൽ യുവർ ബ്രേക്ക്. ഓക്കെ, താങ്ക് യു.